California wildfire victims fear they'll be last in payout. San Francisco, AP, a $13.5 billion settlement between victims of California's catastrophic wildfires and the utility blamed for causing them was supposed to bring some peace and hope to people still reeling from the devastation. Instead, the deal has sparked confusion, resentment, suspicion and despair as the victims, government agencies, and lawyers grapple for their piece of the pie. More than 81,000 have filed claims to the settlement fund, setting the stage for a potential scrum as Pacific Gas and Electric scrambles to emerge from one of the most complex bankruptcy cases in U.S. history by June 30. How is it in any way fair that the actual victims of this fire, or any of the fires, are put at the very, very bottom of the priority list, wrote Michelle Barker, 54, in a recent letter to U.S. bankruptcy judge Dennis Montali, who is overseeing the settlement. Barker lost her home to the 2018 fire that wiped out Paradise, California. The tensions may boil over during a hearing Wednesday focusing on whether federal and state agencies are entitled to tap the fund to recoup any of the $4 billion they doled out after the wildfires. Health chain Adventist Health is also seeking at least $1 billion for losses from its heavily damaged hospital in Paradise, and lawyers could try to take up to a third. Victims are also upset that half the settlement, or $6.75 billion, would be paid in stock from PG&E, the company responsible for ruining their lives. The stock payment may prove a clever strategy, said San Francisco bankruptcy attorney Michael Sweet, because that could make it more difficult for California Governor Gavin Newsom to follow through on threats of a government-backed takeover if PG&E doesn't make reforms. A government takeover would likely cause the company's stock to drop, further diminishing the value of the victim's settlement. They are turning the victims into human shields, Sweet said. You only go into bankruptcy because there isn't enough to go around for everyone. Barker, who lost her Paradise home, is among dozens making passionate pleas to Montali asking him to rework a deal he approved in December. More than 1,600 wildfire victims signed an online petition calling the settlement unfair. PG&E is building off of our losses in a sense, said Jason Meek, 48, whose Northern California wine country home was destroyed in 2017. It's important in my view that this settlement is done with thought and care. The possibility of government agencies tapping the fund has outraged people still looking for new places to live after losing their homes and, in some cases, still grieving loved ones who perished during the worst wildfires in modern U.S. history. Montali, who also presided over PG&E's previous bankruptcy from 2001 to 2004, has never left any doubt that compensated for more on this story, visit the news article link.